Hello and welcome to the Chemistry Solution. This tutorial is on bond polarity, molecule polarity, and dipole moments. Bond polarity is due to a difference in electronegativity between atoms in a bond. Looking at the molecule HF, fluorine is more electronegative than hydrogen and has a greater pull on the bonded electrons than hydrogen does, creating a partial negative charge on fluorine and a partial positive charge on hydrogen. And this difference in charge creates a dipole moment, which we represent with an arrow. Just like bonds can be polar, molecules can also be polar or nonpolar. And whether or not a molecule is polar depends on the sum of the bond dipoles. And so polarity is dependent on the types of bonds in the molecule and also the molecular geometry. Remember that bond dipole moments are vectors. And so in the case of carbon dioxide, you have two polar bonds because there is a difference in electronegativity between oxygen and carbon. However, because these dipole moments are of equal magnitude and opposite direction, they will cancel each other out. And so overall, the molecule CO2 is nonpolar. So a molecule can have polar bonds, but not be a polar molecule. So to determine if a molecule is polar, first you need to draw a correct Lewis structure. Then you need to determine the electron domain geometry and molecular geometry of the molecule. And it's important to keep in mind to remember that how you might draw a Lewis structure on paper is not necessarily what the molecule looks like in three dimensions. Then you need to determine which bonds, if any, are polar. And lastly, determine if the sum of the dipole moments of the polar bonds cancel each other out. Let's look at a couple examples. Determine whether the following molecules are polar or nonpolar. Let's start with H2O. First, we need to draw the correct Lewis structure. In the correct Lewis structure, the central atom, oxygen, has two bonded and two non-bonded pairs. So the next step is to determine the electron domain geometry and the molecular geometry. There are four electron domains surrounding oxygen. This means that the electron domain geometry of this molecule is tetrahedral. Because there are two bonding domains and two non-bonding domains, this means that the molecular geometry is bent. So even though I drew this molecule on paper and it looks like a linear molecule, after determining the electron domain and molecular geometry, we realize that this molecule is bent. And so remember that the molecular geometry is not always evident by how you draw the Lewis structure. Because remember that molecules are three-dimensional, and so sometimes it's hard to draw Lewis structures in three dimensions on your paper. Next, we need to determine which of these bonds are polar. Both of the oxygen-hydrogen bonds in this water molecule are polar. And lastly, we need to determine if the sum of the dipole moments of the polar bonds cancel each other out. Remember that dipole moments are vectors, and so if you remember how to add vectors, we line them up head to tail. When we do that, we can see that these dipole moments, unlike the dipole moments in carbon dioxide, do not cancel each other out. And so because these dipole moments don't cancel, molecules of H2O have a net dipole, so H2O is a polar molecule. Let's look at the molecule BF3. First, we need to draw the correct Lewis structure. Remember, boron is able to violate the octet rule and needs only 6 surrounding valence electrons. For step 2, we determine the electron domain geometry and the molecular geometry. There are 3 electron domains, which means that the electron domain geometry is trigonal planar. 3 of the electron domains are bonding domains, and 0 are non-bonding domains. This means that the molecule also has a trigonal planar molecular geometry. For step 3, we need to determine which bonds are polar. All of the boron-fluorine bonds in this molecule are polar. Because all of these bonds are identical, the magnitude of these dipole moments are equal. You'll also notice that in this case, if you were to draw a perfectly trigonal planar molecule, your Lewis structure is representative of your molecule geometry. And the last step is to determine if the sum of the dipole moments cancel each other out. Remember that all vectors have a horizontal and a vertical component. And so what you'll notice here is that the bottom two bonds in this molecule pull in the horizontal direction with the same magnitude and opposite directions. So the horizontal component of these vectors will cancel each other out. And then you'll also notice that the vertical components of these vectors cancel each other out. Each boron fluorine bond on the bottom of the molecule has a dipole moment in the opposite direction and equal to half of the magnitude of the dipole moment of the boron fluorine bond on the top of the molecule. And so overall, if you were to add these vectors up head to tail, they would cancel each other out. And so because the dipole moments of the boron fluorine bonds and BF3 cancel each other out, BF3 has no net dipole and is a nonpolar molecule. Now it's easy to see how the dipole moments in CO2 cancel each other out. And hopefully you can see how the dipole moments in BF3 cancel each other out. But as you get to more complicated molecular geometries, sometimes it's harder to tell whether or not the dipole moments will cancel each other out. And so anytime you have a central atom bonded to all of the same atoms with all bonding and no non-bonding pairs, this is an important point in this statement, the dipole moments of the bonds will always cancel and the molecule will always be nonpolar. Thanks for watching The Chemistry Solution. We hope you enjoyed this tutorial.